you'll see it in a new way and learn to make conscious use of it. I first became aware of the power of this language in my first job out of college at Boeing. My assignment was to get mechanical engineers and electrical engineers to communicate better, but no one told me how to do that. I started drawing simple block diagrams like this to help my own understanding. And when I showed them to other people, the light went on for them too. Aha! I didn't pursue it at the time, but over the past few years, I've become fascinated with the idea of visual communication. And I've learned that there's a simple visual alphabet that can be used to depict any subject and communicate almost any idea. It looks like this, and it's easy for anyone to learn. But why should you learn a new language? What's wrong with the one you already know? After all, you've spent your whole life learning it, and by now you're pretty good at it. Well, let you decide for yourself which of the following two slides communicates more quickly. Here's the first slide. I'll give you a chance to read it. When you've figured out what two subjects this slide is talking about, please raise your hand. Same thing here. Raise your hand when you know what these are. Pretty easy, huh? Yeah, I've shown you the Wikipedia entries for roses in Maui County. As you just experienced, our brains are very efficient at processing visual input. A photo or a map can help someone get it quicker than describing in words. But what about something complicated and controversial, like the whole healthcare debate that's been going on in Congress? Well, this kind of thing makes me wish someone would sort it out for me in simple pictures. Someone has. Dan Rome created some short hand-drawn presentations explaining the healthcare issue and won a contest on SlideShare for best presentation of the year, as judged by Business Week magazine. He draws on napkins like this one. But you might want to draw on index cards and put them on your blog, like Jessica Hagee does. I hope this presentation will hit the sweet spot on the graph, providing just the right amount of information to minimize your confusion. And this is by Yuen Lau, a cartoonist who draws on the back of business cards. This one is appropriate for tonight, don't you think? Now that computers make it so easy for anyone to create and share visual media, visual literacy is an important life skill. So I'd like to invite you to get in touch with your inner five-year-old, like I did in this drawing, and allow him or her to draw along with me for the next few minutes. We'll practice drawing variations of this simple visual alphabet, then put it all together with a drawing to commemorate tonight's event. So turn over your paper to the blank side, and let's loosen up with a scribble. Just scribble. Draw squiggles or jaggy lines. Draw fast or slow. Press hard or soft. Just draw all over that sheet. Now turn your paper over and try drawing some of the shapes in frame one. Notice that there are straight lines and curved lines. Open shapes and closed shapes. I know this space is pretty crowded on your sheet, so just feel free to trace or draw on the sides or the margins. Now let's move to frame two and draw some lines. They can be horizontal, vertical, diagonal. They can be long, short, thick, thin, repeated, and combined to form many useful shapes. Now try drawing some of the line combinations in frame three. Straight line shapes are useful for man-made objects and showing order or structure, as in blueprints or process flow diagrams. Arrows show motion or direction, how to get from here to there. Moving on to frame four, explore the variety of curved line shapes. Curved shapes are useful for drawing natural objects and representing unity and flow. All right, you guys are getting into it. And now try drawing some of the shapes in frame 5, which combine curved and straight lines to make some familiar and useful symbols. Or look around and draw something you see, noticing how it's made up of those simple elements. And draw a map in frame 6, showing the way from your house to the elephant egg in Bahia. First we'll draw Maui. Mark your home with an X. Draw an elephant egg in Bahia and some arrows to show the route. Now when you combine the shapes of this visual alphabet with words, the language you already know, you get a new language, visual language, that can help you communicate better with anyone, from your family to coworkers to friends around the world. Thank you very much for your attention and your participation. If you'd like to learn more about anything I've shown you tonight, there are some links and references on your handout. I'm Karen Bennett, and I've enjoyed sharing some ideas about visual language with you.